How's the audio? How's the audio? Okay. Hang on, I got some dropped frames here. I don't know, but I think the first frames were kind of weird, so it seems to be stable now. I've written it wrong. Osyssey. Odyssey. Well, a new event just started here for the cool new Deluxe outfit, but I never followed the news about Genshin. Hey, that's a different animation, isn't it? Different system, different animation. I never realized. I don't usually use them. I'm using one for Jin, but I didn't notice any different animation. But yeah, I don't know if everything's already available here. Even though, yeah, it's due for this one. I'm delaying this one for way too long. That's part of the same quest. Hello. That's the one from, yeah.
I'm all for work-life balance, but...
I've been avoiding this scattering for quite a while now. I think I'm gonna avoid getting, try to complete the map and stuff now. I just focus on the story, and if I have to, I'll collect something, but I'll mostly avoid everything so I can gather all the collectibles at once at the end.
Traveler, it so happens that a friend of yours asked me to pass on a message when I saw you.
Someone left a message for us? Who can it be?
My beloved retainer, have you noticed that silver thread of which fate is woven, now twisting and twining itself around you? The Aug de Vertelung does Grossen Kaleido Phantasmus will be watching you.
Mostad is kind of based in Germany, right? And she had some difficulty pronouncing German words. They travel to Liu and Inazuma, and Paimon instantly knows how to say any word, any names, without any issue. But here Catherine had some trouble with German. Well, it's quite, I didn't understand, but it's quite obvious who wrote it.
Apologies. This message is unusually difficult to recite. Would you like to hear more?
Sure.
Definitely sounds like Fischl's note. What should we do?
Oh, I'd love to hear more.
We'll be watching you as you step into the glorious castle of the Immer Nachreich. Come to me at once. Swear an oath to me in my blessed name, and we shall journey together to the depths of the world. Anyway, to summarize, Miss Fischl asked me to ask you to go to the plaza in front of the cathedral.
Okay.
Please meet her there when you have the time. She said that she will be waiting for you.
Oh, Fischl. Such a mystifying message for such a plain and simple request.
Couldn't she say pause?
Well, if Fischl's expecting us, then let's not keep her waiting. Let's head towards the cathedral plaza.
I'm always traveling the world and she's just there waiting for me.
Yeah.
Mona is up here already.
There she is! And Mona too!
Oh! Welcome, welcome, most loyal attendants of the Princessin.
None there's that far. Was she never part of the story, just events? Official possessing of Verultalum have descended upon this realm from mine Imeravan, executed by Destiny Doom. Each and every day my familiar eyes and I observe every weft and weave of fate. Apologies, Miss Fischel of the Adventurers Guild can be hard to understand at times. I would like to remind you on behalf of the guild that the Fish Dictionary is there for you should you fail to comprehend her words. May I also ask her companion, Mr. Oz, for help. Overall, however, Miss Fischel is most trustworthy investigator. I hope that you will work well together. It's about time to...
Which one is it? Retainer or attendant? Make up your mind.
She's using the other quotes.
My apologies. Main Fräulein tends to use exaggerated expressions when she's in good spirits.
Hey, Fischl! You were looking for us, right? Sounds like the fun started without us. What's got you in such a good mood?
Let's see you all again. It's been a while.
And so, the whisper of eternal night summons you back to my side. Splendid. What a blessed reunion. A boon from beyond the eventide. Come, partake of this joy with me, my subjects.
Traveler, Paimon, it's a pleasure to see you again. Main Fräulein and I extend to you our most sincere greetings.
Paimon wants to say a proper hello too, but Paimon has no idea how to, partake.
A normal person in this situation would simply say, "Hi, traveler, how have you been?"
Hi, thanks.
The traveler and I are like intertwined stars in the vast galaxy. You of all people should very well know the fate foretold by this meeting.
Precisely. Lady Majestis, please refrain from such unimaginative utterances.
Come on.
Lady A what now?
Is that a new nickname?
Lady Majestis has long since become a citizen of the Imenokreich. She has been serving as court archmage under one's command for some time now.
That's just my surname. Don't mind that. This is so embarrassing. You're here because Fischl asked Catherine to ask you to come, right?
Indeed so, my archmage. Did even this appear in thy divination? Why, your powers are truly dangerous.
Oh, for the love of... No, of course not. You told me yourself that you'd left a message with Catherine. Excuse me. Anyway, in my case, she practically beat the door down to get me to come along. Whatever she says, please, don't be too astonished.
Don't worry. We've been around the block. You can't faze us.
Oh, faithful servants. One's homeland, the Imenokreich, which bears the darkest of all fates, draws near to this world once more. Stand with me in anticipation, for the glory of our kingdom is nigh.
Wait, what?
Indeed. Only one's most faithful envoys are fortunate enough to be privy to this great revelation. The Imenokreich is near Mondstadt.
Okay, I'll first report this... Or report this to Les Favens Minji. Why?
No, please. That will be most unnecessary.
I know it sounds absurd, but there's actually something behind this, I promise. Basically, what Fischl means is...
Lady Majestis!
All right, all right. Honestly, Look at me, a genius astrologist forced into a juvenile role-playing game. The truth is that yesterday, Her Highness encountered the Spark Knight Klee outside of the city. Both being of great fame, they recognized one another instantly and began to converse.
That must have been a weird exchange.
It was already getting dark, so, in that spirit of great compassion and care for which she is known, Her Highness personally accompanied Klee back to Mondstadt. On the way, Her Highness relayed to Klee the story of her origins. Upon hearing the tragic tale of the fall of Her Highness's homeworld, the tender-hearted Spark Knight inquired, with tears welling up in her eyes.
Oh no! Is the Imanakreish really gone? Won't it grow back?
Oh, mortal! Your sovereign's heart is touched by thy sincerity and sympathy. But nay, the Imanakreish is an everlasting realm, and one day, it shall make its reappearance.
Really? So how do we make your homeland grow back again? Oh, please tell me. Please, please.
For us.
Since you inquire so earnestly, give unto me a tranquil haven. Promise me eternal admiration. Lend me both time and wind, and one shall revive one's homeworld.
Okay, how?
Could you cut the reenactments and just get to the point?
In short, Klee gave Fischl an island to serve as the promised land where the Imanakreish will appear. I didn't believe it either at first, but then I saw this letter.
Mistress Letter, extreme resizing of Imanakreish. I am a witch who travels amidst the mountains and rivers of Teyvat. I write to you, having heard from my young daughter, that your kingdom has fallen and that you are searching for a way to restore it. Amid the seas, under a far-flung sky, may the Golden Apple Archipelago be found. That wasn't a precise location. If this masterless land can assist in the restoration of your highness' realm, that would be most wonderful. What about the people of the realm? Didn't they die? I don't remember. But it's too convoluted, her story.
Providence has gifted Main Fräulein with an excellent opportunity. Esteemed traveler, as Main Fräulein's cherished retainer, you deserve to bear witness to this grand moment with us.
This island looks kind of familiar.
Traveler,
curtail thy umming and awing at once. The throne of the Imanakreish calls for me. Come, be my blade. Clear the way and witness what is to come.
I think she just wants to invite you along to the island with her. That being said, I have a feeling that I'll be better off not performing any divination where that island's concerned.
Huh?
Why?
Why not?
Klee is involved in this, which means her mother is probably involved, which means that old hag is involved. Thanks, but no thanks.
What can I do for you, your highness?
You, who have traveled to the farthest reaches of the world, fathom the celestial path of stardust in the palm of your hand, and witness raindrops converge and become one with the undercurrent of destiny. You, yes, you...
must chart the course that leads the way to the land promised to Main Fräulein by fate.
Oh, Fischl doesn't know the way there.
I knew it.
since thou asketh for our help, Paimon can telleth you that we are good friends with the Spark Knight Klee, the guides of destiny. Come on, just play along.
Do I have to? Very well, I am the one whom hath traveled there, here from beyond the stars.
Behold, the watcher, the guide, the weaver of dreams, the traveler.
Excellent, most excellent.
a probably amuse most others watch spectacle changes for
to sum up, traveler, since you say you know the way, we'll let you take us to the island. I mean the promised land.
No, let me just leave it to me.
Oh, good, fine, done. Right now, Lady Magistus needs to go home to pack her things and catch up on some sleep. Your Highness, your other distinguished selves, let's meet at the city gate at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Okay, she's going along and stuff, but why?
Very well, then it is settled. One blesses you with an undisturbed slumber, Lady Magistus. You too, traveler.
If she's already getting involved, what's wrong with her figuring out the way by divination?
Main Fräulein means to say, good night. See you all tomorrow.
About darn time! Good night! Oh, Paimon's exhausted! You all have proper rules! How come Paimon has to be a clock on the wall in the royal palace? Cuckoo! It's 12 o'clock sharp in the Immer Nachtreich!
Well, you're the one who started.
Anyway, since those islands are a pretty mind-blowing place, why don't we get some people with mind-boggling ideas to help us out? Kaya's mind works in mysterious ways. But no one in Mondstadt has ideas that boggle the mind quite like a certain somebody who's definitely going to be in the tavern at this hour. Come on, let's go rope him into helping us.
Oh, damn. If I go to the tavern, I may start the other quest by accident. Let me check this. Oh no, this same image of the winery. Oh, okay. I thought it was the tavern that I was going to. But isn't quite often at the tavern anyway. Shouldn't he go more to the cat's tails because he don't get along with Diluc? Okay, the other one I can think of would be the barge and Rosaria. Or Diluc, but I don't know why we would take any of them there.
We're here! Tone deaf bard!
It is him.
What are they doing in Mondstadt?
Oh, they got to know. Kazuha got to know. Thank you.
Well, look at that! You're really here! Come on, take a seat and join our delightful conversation.
And Kazuha probably got to know Shinyan aboard the Brooks fleet.
Wow! Traveler! Paimon! Speak of the devil! We were literally just talking about you!
Truly a curious coincidence.
Kazuha? Shinyan? What are you doing here in a Mondstadt tavern? And how'd you end up having to share a table with the tone-deaf bard?
Tone-deaf bard? Now that's a fun stage name. It seems like you're a pretty well-known singer, fella.
Though sadly not a rock and roll singer, or we could perform a duet. So, you all know each other. My newfound friends are my old friends' friends from afar. How fantastic. Oh, this is a rare opportunity indeed! Oh, we should form a poetry club and call it, the Free Poet Society, or something like that.
You guys came here from there.
Yeah, I felt like getting out and finding some new inspiration for my songwriting. Kazuha felt like going on a trip too, so we figured we'd travel together. Last month, Beto held a big booze-filled party called the Drink Till You Sink Championship, and she put me in charge of the music. That's where I met Kazuha.
Although Xinyan can come across as unruly at times, her musical understanding is highly nuanced and original. Safe to say, our shared appreciation for music struck a chord in us both.
Oh yeah, it plays as well.
Oh, you can say that again. In Kazuha's hands, even a leaf becomes an instrument. That makes him an expert among my friends. Starting from Liyue, we passed through Stone Gate and kept going until we came into Mondstadt. Then along the way, we saw this really awesome manor. It was something else.
Oh yeah, we know the one. Our friend owns that place.
Really? Y'all sure have a lot of friends. Well, whoever it is that lives in that fine place must be really loving life, huh?
Guess so.
Similar souls tend to attract each other. Traveler and Paimon, you must have exceptional taste, just like that friend of yours.
Wow, you're too nice! Unlike some people who only ever seem to poke fun at Paimon. Ahem.
By the way, do you know anything about the Iridescence Tour? It's supposed to be huge. Rumor has it that all seven nations of Teyvat are gonna be involved.
I can't remember. I don't remember. Never
well,
heard of this.
So far it's mostly just empty promises. Anyway, it's supposed to be a music festival. The organizer really did a number on me last time. They canceled on me. But I hear that they're still active.
Okay. Yeah, I think you mentioned something about it. That's why you were stuck me in a Zoom.
I'd love to give the festival another shot. But wouldn't you know it? The plans fell through again. How can they mess up this bad twice in a row?
Music is all about inspiration. Maybe the organizers canceled the show because theirs dried up. But fear not, weary travelers, for your journey was not in vain. It has, after all, brought you here, to me, to the Temple of Music.
Your Temple of Music must have more than just good tunes. You're a bard, ain't you? A song's gotta have a good story or it doesn't make the cut, right?
Exactly. Oh, you understand the meaning of being a bard so well. To express my gratitude, I will even share one of these stories with you.
Oh, you're a funny fella. Are all bards like you?
I've met many bards during my travels, but none of them are as entertaining as you.
I'm sure it all comes down to the richness of my imagination and, by extension, the poverty of theirs. And on that note, here is a fantastical tale that is sure to delight you all. Legends tell of an emerald isle in the middle of the ocean. There, the Dodo King and his people live a blissful existence. When a Dodoko is born, it dives into the water. Some learn to swim. Others are carried away by the waves, all the way to Mondstadt, where they befriend the children there. One Dodoko made a new friend in Mondstadt, the little Spark Knight. But the Dodo King did not approve. He demanded that the little knight come to the island and prove herself to him. So the little knight, together with her most important friend in the world, braved the wind and waves, finally reaching the middle of the ocean. But Dodo King was not there. Dodo King had lied. There was no trial, by fire or interrogation. The little knight's mother, who was a mage, had built an entire summer city there as a gift to her daughter, along with this message. Summer is the season of love. It is the time for freedom and fun. So everyone, please sing, dance, and enjoy yourselves here.
Okay, so that is the last chapter of the, what's the name? Gotenapo Archipelago. That happens. Oh yeah, wasn't I supposed to be playing while telling this story?
The end.
Come on. This tree shows the most best about the animals.
How interesting. I now have the urge to visit that island myself. This is the thing about traveling. You can't plan ahead. Better to leave when the mood takes you and go where the heart leads.
I'm glad you liked it. Well, there's wine on the table and I have stories to tell. Seems like fate is feeling kind today.
Here's to music. Come on, traveler.
Don't worry, if you don't like wine, there's juice as well.
In that case, I'll have a glass of juice. This one. I like the color.
Somehow I get right drink one glass and there's never enough time to read that.
Kazuha!
What?
Uh-oh. This fella's drunk. But wasn't he drinking fruit juice?
More. More.
That's not what's
more, please.
Oops. I think I accidentally placed some fruity cocktails out there. My bad.
Seriously?
Anyway, guess it's time to talk about business after all that drinking. You came here because you need my help, I presume?
Oh yeah, that's a good point! We didn't come here to drink.
Genshin, come with me. But apparently I don't know what you got there.
Kazuha! Oh, he just won't wake up. Looks like we're staying in the tavern tonight.
What would you like? I need to learn to handle my booze better.
Where am I supposed to go?
Even if you are a close friend.
Look where we are. Yup, I can sense that you're about to tell me something very interesting.
Lee
gave a special gift from her mother to an adventurer friend? Oh, she's such a kind-hearted child. As I'm sure you've already guessed, that letter is most definitely written by Alice.
Yeah, that's so.
Speaking of, guess which two people I ran into on my way to the tavern today?
Master Jean? Or Lisa?
A mother and daughter. Both with long elf ears and the most amazingly adorable personalities.
Did you get to meet elves?
Alice and Klee?
Ding, ding, ding! Correct answer! The unaging mage was taking her teeny tiny knight on a vacation, and I happened to run into them. As a friendly greeting, the mysterious woman gave me a gift. She also said that if I meet any fun friends, I should share this gift with them. So now it's yours to keep.
She knows the future and stuff, doesn't she? She predicts how everything will turn out on the island and stuff. I bet she knows he's the animal archon.
It's a bomb!
Minus the fuse, so don't worry, it's not going to explode. Come on, take it! This way we can talk to each other just like this, even when we're apart.
It's an walkie-talkie. That sounds impressive.
It's called a Dodo communication device, and it allows people to stay in touch over vast distances. However, you can't just use it anytime you want, and there's also a limit on the number of times you can use it. That's why it's currently only available to a certain select few. I heard that the inspiration for this comes from another world. Alice is always full of surprises. She and Klee asked me to tell you. Please take this with you when you depart for the island. No, wait. The promised land with your friends. And have fun! Don't worry about how to get there. The organizers of this vacation have made arrangements. Turn right after you exit the city gates, and you'll see something that will make you very happy.
Sounds like the two of you are in cahoots over this.
Of course not.
Is that really the sort of person you think I am?
Totally.
Traveler, you're my friend. And as your friend, I just want to give you something that'll make you happy. How can you think this of me?
Fair enough. The tone-deaf bard does like to joke around, but he's still one of our best friends.
Is he?
Besides, a vacation sounds great! Actually, Kazuha and Shinyan seemed pretty interested in coming on this trip, too. Let's ask them if they want to join us.
Wow, that was fast. That was a nice cut.
Ah, you're back. Poor Kazuha's still out for the count. Seems like he can't handle alcohol so well.
Shinyan, do you want to come to the islands with us?
Adventure. Can't.
Huh? He doesn't want to go anymore. He seemed really interested just a moment ago.
What if he can't wait?
Can't miss the adventure.
Oh. Kazuha might act mature, but deep down he's just another youngster eager for new experiences. That must be why he didn't think anything of the fruit juice earlier.
Well, all the more reason for you to join the island trip. You know, a lot of people have praised the beautiful scenery there. Even bards.
A lot of people.
Okay, sounds like a plan. How do we get there?
Someone's got it covered, apparently. There'll be a few others joining us on this trip, and we're meeting at the city gate tomorrow morning. We'll wait for you.
Kazuha, wake up. We're going wandering.
Traveler?
Oh, yeah. They don't know official yet, do they? Okay, so here's the deal. There's a princess from a faraway land and her retinue, who are also coming on this trip.
Huh?
Can we sell tickets and invite more people like that?
Paimon, don't get me wrong. I'm just asking to make sure. But from the way you're plugging this trip so hard, did the Iridescence Tour folks put you up to this? After all, canceling the Iridescence Tour after people already made the trip, that's kind of the same thing as tricking people into going traveling, ain't it?
But, well, you'll have to spend money for them, so what's the point of tricking people in going traveling elsewhere?
And not giving you anything. Why won't anyone believe Paimon?
Don't worry about that for now. You'll all have the chance to get acquainted with each other tomorrow morning. Whether you're a princess, a retainer, a talking raven, a samurai, or a musician, you're all VIP guests of the island on your summer vacation. And that's what counts, right?
Isn't he a ronin?
I'm sure looking forward to it.
Are you coming too?
I'll have to pass. I have some work to take care of.
You serious? The tone-deaf bard actually has plans to do some work?
I promised a young lady with cat ears and a cat tail that I'd sing at her tavern to boost business and beat the competition. Ah, yes. The competition being this place, which has six-fingered Jose.
Aren't you allergic to cats?
Yes?
Yup. I can always sing on their roof. She told me that as long as their sales surpass their competitor, there's a whole month's worth of wine in it for me. Oh, what a fine employment opportunity. Virtually tailor-made for me. So have fun. And don't worry about me. I feel like this summer is going to be a very interesting one.
Who's better?
Kazuha? Kazuha!
Yes, I think. I have to put this.
Today is the day of one's reckoning with fate, as foretold by the night sky. Humiliation suffered in the past, the shame we have carried all these years, one bids you adieu, for today it is time for retribution.
Main Fräulein, if I may be so bold, that final phrase did not sound like one of your own.
Of course it wasn't. I just overheard it from someone in the city.
It's so much better stuff like that.
I mean, thy princessin is merely drawing on the wisest and courageous saying she has heard in the land to signify the importance of this day.
Let me see. It really is someone else's catchphrase.
Do we need to double check that?
Wow, you're here early.
Hi. Who have you brought with you?
Oh, ahem. Allow Paimon to introduce to you a fabled wandering swordsman of Inazuma and an enchanting musical talent of Liyue.
Hey! I'm Xinyan from Liyue. I like rock and roll, sunny days, and good times.
She's giving a bio description.
You must be the princess Paimon told us about. You sure do look the part. I hear you're from a faraway land. It's an honor to be in the company of dignitaries. And this lady over here. My family tells me that only the wisest scholars wear pointed hats like this one. Guess that applies to you too?
You can just buy a pointy hat.
Oh, I like her. She can stay.
Xinyan, your gaze pierces the dark veil of night to arrive at the truth beyond. I am in need of one such as yourself. Very well. You shall be one's musician laureate.
She's trying to say thanks. You say all the right things. And the same goes for me, too. Pleasure to meet you. I'm Mona, an astrologist.
Oh, well, it's nice to meet you, too.
Mona is amazing. She can find out everything about you by divination.
A princess, an astrologist, and an articulate raven retainer. In the company of giants, my humble self hardly deserves mention. I am Kaida Harakazuha from Inazuma. It is an honor to meet you all.
What ho, Kazuha? Divulge thy epithets and thy vocation.
Yes.
Oh, Main Fräulein would like to know where you work and what your field of expertise is.
I'm afraid I'm just another wanderer.
This guy is an expert in the sword arts. He parries blades that none have ever parried before, and strikes like lightning mere mortals could not hope to comprehend.
What? Is he really that powerful?
Let me take a look. Huh? Oh my. Hi, Kazuha. I'm absolutely delighted to meet a great swordmaster like you. Could we ask you to be our guard while we're on the island?
One hereby declares you captain of the Royal Guard of the Imanakreich.
But he just got a citizenship.
For even Lady Magistus to praise your skills, you are surely one of rare talent.
The Magistus is absolutely right.
Okay, Lady Mag...
Lady Magic... What?
Oh, just call me Mona. Stop calling me that weird name.
It's her surname.
By the way, Lady Justice, we found out how to get to the Promised Land. A legendary great mage gave us a big hint. Come on, everyone. Follow Paimon.
It is nearby. Okay.
Um. Look, everyone! Here's our vehicle!
I thought we'd go by sea.
Somehow, I suddenly don't feel like going anymore.
What a, unique little thing. Looks kinda like Guoba, doesn't it?
Have I ever seen her? I don't think I've met them, but they're quite famous.
Guoba. Is he the magical creature at Wanmin Restaurant? Now that you mention it, it does look quite similar.
To be honest, even Paimon isn't so sure this can take us to the island after all.
I see. Only by meeting the lowliest of ends can we arrive at the Imanakreish born anew. Ho ho! Behold, the doorway cloven by thundering retribution. By such means as I once descended into this realm to bring retribution, do I now venture into the next. Come, Oz, lead the way.
I will enter first. Main Fräulein need not worry.
He's in. And now he's gone!
Why, this truly is the path of retribution that leads to the Promised Land.
Maybe I should just do
a quick reading for safety.
Lady Magistus, it's fine! This is Alice's creation. It's totally safe. Spare yourself the trouble. Just come with us.
Yeah, I think something else built is safe. Is properly working. But we don't know her. It could explode.
Oh, right. I completely forgot. All right.
Well. Everyone exchanged 94, one by one, and save nervously. Total Fortress, where was the name of that?
It's so dark in here. Can someone turn on a light? Hey, quit pushing!
Come on now, let's all try and stay. Ow! Fischl, you're treading on my hair! I thought it was a snake! we're flying!
Everyone, be careful.
But it only started working after everybody entered. I thought it had teleported us already. What? It wasn't responding for a moment.
We finally landed. What was that all about?
What a beautiful place. The wind is soft and the ocean is calm. And a pleasant scent blows on the breeze.
Of life and a land filled with flora. Main Fräulein, we have finally arrived at the Promised Land, whence we shall revive the Imanakreish.
Oh, faithful retainers, this is the blessed paradise that one has been searching for. Here is where we shall witness the culmination of all things. I, who command the darkness, shall lead you to yonder gate of dreams. Shall lead you to yonder gate of dreams.
Your Archmage Magistus thanks you for your kindness, Your Highness. In this moment, I offer my blessings to the Imanakreish.
Oh, shit. Forced to go along with that.
Mona, what are you,
Don't ask. Just follow my lead.
Oh, right. Praise be to the princessin who has led us here to this sacred place.
My sincere gratitude to you for inviting me to join you on this trip, Your Highness.
Your happiness gladdens one's heart. How it delights me to bring us all together here at this most monumentally fateful of moments. Now, as I take my first step on this pilgrimage, I shall perceive this ocean of life with my own earthly vessel. After all, this is where my soul belongs. On the contrary, Lady Magistus, blessed as you are with the great power of Hydro, one yet finds too many impurities in thy soul.
Main Fräulein means Lady Magistus is perhaps not the most talented swimmer.
What?
Oh, official! That's enough! I'm happy enough to join in with the play acting without complaining, but how dare you ridicule my genius! Think you can swim better than me? Ha! I'll bring you to your knees, young lady!
Oh my, Main Fräulein! Steel yourself, Main Fräulein!
Oh yeah! Swimming race, swimming race! Whoever comes in last is a rotten egg!
Challenge accepted! Heed my words, lowly Lady Magistus! You shall pay for your foolishness for as long as you live!
Ridiculous! I've never lost a single swimming race in my life! Bring it on! First one to run to the beach wins!
Are they serious? Running? I thought they were gonna swim!
There, man. Looks like they're enjoying this. Nobody can really swim.
I take it you have no present plans. I want to start by surveying the area first. Want to come along?
Yes, sir. It's good we can count on you.
Xinyan, are you coming?
Seems like everyone's got things to do. I'll stay here and hold down the fort for now. Mona and Fischl have gone swimming and someone's got to set up camp.
You see, you're ready already.
Don't worry, I got this. You're gonna take a look around, right? Well, make sure you let me know if there are any good views.
Thanks, will do!
But those are we supposed to follow? Official's instructions here, or whatever, on how to build the kingdom.
Okay, I'll start by catching 10 crabs and 20 fish. Will that be enough for all of us? Maybe I should prepare something else.
Oh, I got another projector already. But the other two aren't around anymore. Yeah, if I'm already free to go anywhere like that, since I played the last event here, the reporters could be active. Hang on, didn't this island had like I don't know, wouldn't this the archipelago sink again to the bottom of the ocean? It was like a rare event that it resurfaced. So did Alice just pull this from the water again? Oh, good, those sculptures appear on the mini-map already.
To be some sort of machine and an army cap with traces of hydro next to it. It seems that we are not the first to set foot on this island. Also, there are footprints here, fresh ones, likely no more than a few days old.
Really? Hyman didn't notice them at all.
There are footprints on the beach. They are a few days old. Shouldn't they have been washed out? Come on. Can we just follow them?
Traveler, Paimon, stay alert.
Why? Did you see something?
Someone was here. And they're still nearby. Judging from the scent, they're visitors here like us.
There's other people here? Oh, Paimon's scared now. Come on, we need to track him down. You said the cap had traces of hydro on it? Then let's follow the traces of elemental energy.
Come on. I hate using that. Spare shoes. No, it's here. Yeah.
We're close. Watch out.
It's the Fatui!
Didn't he drop his hat?
Our bond is strong.
Freshness preserved.
Incoming.
Chill.
Nowhere to hide.
Disgusting.
Hang on. This wasn't.
Why is there Fatui on this island?
A hydro.
Isn't there a single place in this world without mint, sweet flowers, and Fatui?
And there are, like weeds.
Interesting observation.
Cappy Cap's gone! Where's Cappy Cap?
Are you looking for something?
A cap! I can't lose it! I don't know anything! Give me back Cappy Cap!
Is this the cap you're looking for?
My brother's Cappy Cap! Gimme!
This the sharpest sword in the sheath.
Don't bully me or I'll punch you in the... Monster! Monster!
Stop right there! What are you doing here?
Another Fatus! We can ask you the same question! What are you doing here?
Protect Cappy Cap, or brother will get mad at me.
Forget the cap. It's your brother we're looking for.
What happened to him?
Nothing. He has a fever. He's just a little delirious, that's all. I don't have to tell you anything. Go bother someone else.
This island belongs to our friend. You better watch what you say, mister.
What? I thought this island was uninhabited. That's why we came here to... Never mind.
What's the machine for?
Fine. I'll tell you, but then you need to leave me alone. It's a new kind of energy generator that I invented. We were simply looking for a deserted island to test it out on. There. Satisfied?
Like I told you, the island's ours. Do not beat our vacationing. No, come on. We're basically the guards around here. Shouldn't we arrest them?
Yeah, and if you don't do as you're told, we'll, we'll take his cap!
Please don't!
Hey, stop crying! All right, I promise we'll stay within this area. Okay?
By the way, why is there smoke coming out of your machine?
Because the cursed thing is broken. As much as I hate to say it, our tests did not go to plan. You were getting ready to leave anyway.
Oh, well, just see yourselves out whenever you're ready. Bye.
Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Paimon can't believe we have to deal with the Fatui during our vacation!
Why would the Fatui appear in such an isolated corner of the world? Whatever their reasons, it's likely more complicated than we might think. Even though we're on vacation, we should stay vigilant.
Great.
Also, in the interests of keeping the ladies in good spirits, I have a suggestion. Let's keep this between us for now. Let them enjoy their vacation while the Traveler and I deal with any potential threats. What do you think?
Makes sense.
You're so considerate, Kazuha.
I don't know. I think Fischer would like us to arrest them.
Paimon, you flatter me. I simply don't think it's worth ruining anyone's vacation over a trivial matter like this.
They're the Fatui. They're half the reason the war is starting in Azuma.
The scenery is beautiful. I hope all of us can enjoy ourselves here.
Return to camp. So... I didn't stop by. Hang on, is there a statue? No, there are statues around here. Okay, I don't remember what I would have to do here to unlock more of the map. Oh, maybe it was the Wave Rider thing. I don't know, don't remember the name of that thing.
We're back!
Just in time. So, Traveler, Paimon, who do you think the real swimming champion is? Me or Fischl?
You, but just because I'm not such a fan of Fischl.
Utter my supreme name and see how Lady Magistus, the presumptuous, is reduced to bitter tears.
And go forever. Paimon is doing it.
Oh, no, you don't! Don't put this on Paimon!
Oh, wise Paimon. Surely you can discern who the true winner is.
Lady Paimon, the time to show your loyalty is nigh.
Wait, 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 wait. Shouldn't Paimon get some food in her first? Poor thing looks starving after such a long trek out.
Oh, thank you, Xinyan.
Yes, we did walk quite a long way.
We didn't walk.
Right? While you were off doing your own things, I caught us some seafood and picked us a few fruits. They taste real good barbecued.
Now that you mention it, I'm getting a little peckish myself.
I too.
Well, there's plenty to go around, so dig in. I can't say I've got the culinary skills of my chef friend, but I promise you'll at least eat your fill.
Mmm, time to eat!
Inviting Lady Xinyan here was an astute decision indeed.
Paimon's done talking. You guys carry on if you want to go hungry.
I love that barbecue smell. This tastes amazing.
Impressive.
Since Xinyan made dinner for us, allow me to take charge of breakfast tomorrow.
Great, I'm looking forward to it already.
Paimon too! Oh, Traveler, you forgot about something. Let's talk over there. With the Fatui is bothering you too, right? Well, remember the bomb thing that Venti gave us? We can contact him using that. Wait, no, not a bomb. Venti said it's called a Dodo communication device. Yeah, let's ask Venti if he knows anything. He always seems clued in on everything, so if there's any intel floating around, he'll definitely know about it.
Will he?
Hey, miss me already?
It's me.
I know that. You're the only person who can contact me on this thing.
How come you're sneezing?
I'm a cat's tail. So many cats. They gave me some allergy medicine, but it's not working. Okay, go on then. What are you calling about?
I will tell
you. Could you be any lazier?
Well?
Alright, well, Venti, there's some strange things going on this island. We ran into the Fatui!
The Fatui? Yeah, they're everywhere, aren't they? The Cryo Archon's minions are a capable crew. I'd be more surprised if they hadn't shown up yet.
But they're ruining our vacation!
Not really.
Really? But, you sound fine.
So far.
They can't have caused you too much trouble, surely. Or... If they did, I'm sure you have everything under control by now.
Yeah, we just spent... He said we had limited calls.
Yeah, but something just doesn't feel right. That's why we came to you. Don't you have any information for us?
I haven't heard anything new about the Fatui. But don't worry. I may be a lowly tone-deaf bard, but you may contact me whenever you need me. I mean, I can't promise I'll be of much help, but at least you'll have someone to talk to, right? Sometimes just talking things through is enough to calm a worried mind.
Ugh, honestly.
Adventuring is what you do best. It's only natural to encounter a few surprises when you head somewhere new, but just remember, not all unexpected encounters are dangerous. The same wind graces the seaside as that which wafts over pastures green. Whenever you see clouds, it was the wind that carried them there. Don't worry, my friends. The wind will always be with you.
Yeah, как Казуха. You'll be a better Арку.
Okay, then. I have to go now. My performance in the cat's tail is starting any second.
Okay, bye. So, he means we don't need to worry too much about the Fatui, right?
I think so.
If that's what the tone-deaf bard says, then fingers crossed we'll have a peaceful and relaxing vacation where nothing weird happens at all. When you go off on a long trip with your friends, the important thing is to have fun.
I mean, it's nice to go on vacation and do nothing, but it'd be kind of boring if that was actually the case here. 6 a.m. First you have sleep, you mean it sounds like people talking.
Wake up! Traveler, wake up!
I don't want you, but I can't leave Paimon unattended. I don't want you.
Oh, thank goodness you're awake! Paimon has good news and bad news. Which one do you want to hear first?
Bad news. I don't have a choice. Why did she ask if I don't have a choice?
Okay, Paimon, sorry! Wake up! Something's happened!
Oh, I need
to... Okay, bad news first. The bad news is, something weird's going on with this island.
That's not bad.
And the good news
is... That's just news.
Is... It seems like it has nothing to do with what we came across yesterday. Today is a different issue entirely.
This isn't good. It's just news. And what might that be?
Look! He's awake!
Another boat?
Careful not to frighten him. He's probably just like the others. Humans.
What?
Such delicate little things.
It took me a while to notice the squirrel.
How are you doing, mate? Feeling a little fragile?
So, as you can see, the boat can talk.
I might just go back to sleep for a bit.
No! Avoidance isn't gonna solve anything!
Poor soul. Imagine being scared of talking squirrels and boats.
I'm more curious, why is there a squirrel in an island without trees in the middle of the ocean? Oh, why did the boat pick him up elsewhere and brought him here?
Well, we can't blame him. After all, humans aren't quite accustomed to hearing things like us talk.
Wait, have you guys always been able to talk?
Of course! Otherwise, how would we communicate with others of our kind?
That's a good point.
So in other words, we suddenly gained the ability to understand you? How strange.
Maybe you've gained some intelligence. Congratulations.
So you're finally awake. Time to rise and shine.
Oh, you're back.
Well, we've always talked to us.
Yes, we went for a little walk. The enchanting scenery and pleasant weather here soothes the body and mind.
So they don't know about the news yet?
Everything is fine, except that some places are a little peculiar.
Oh, the servants of darkness have descended. Rejoice, for the return of the Imanokreich is nigh.
Main Fräulein means that this is an unexpected development, and she has never seen anything like this before.
What she said.
Yeah.
Oh, my apologies. Please take that as my own opinion.
What happened?
After last night, there have been some unusual spectacles on this island.
Yes. Swimming birds, flying squirrels, the sun and moon in the sky together. Some of these sights only lasted for a moment, but that doesn't make it any less bizarre.
Sun and moon in the sky together. Oh, okay. Here, it's normal. Not there.
I heard a strange flapping sound on the island, but didn't see a single flying creature around.
There's one just next to us. Oh, and I say Paimon is a flying creature as well. But...
There was also a peculiar floral scent on the wind. Though there are many flowers on this island, that scent did not resemble any of them.
And this guy is a superhuman.
Seems to me like whatever these things are, they aren't visible to the naked eye.
I tried to perform a divination, but my scryglass showed only a chaotic mess that was impossible to decipher.
Oh, Paimon has a bad feeling about this. Oh, what have we gotten ourselves into?
I had resolved
to summon the Imanakraish in this land, but now we observe these puzzling phenomena. Could this be the spawn of the condemned trying to thwart my sacred endeavor?
Wait, you don't think Alice could be behind all this, do you?
It's not impossible.
But if it really was her, it wouldn't make sense to do all this.
It would probably make a bit in the end.
Look at them, old chap. Seems we scared the pants off them.
Aye, well, they've never seen anything like this before. This old boat sailed all over the briny seas in its time, and tried talking to many a sailor, too. But in all that time, not a single person has ever spoken back.
Exactly! If it weren't for this environment, who would have thought humans would be able to chat with us?
This environment? What do you mean by that?
Oh, the environment? Could it be that... that the environment is what's interfering with my divinations.
Huh? I might be still dreaming.
Even if you were. Dreams aren't supposed to become reality, right? And a dream won't make you suddenly understand boats and squirrels.
What's wrong?
Look! Over there!
Oh, good thing. Was that supposed to be
an
her
illusion?
Kingdom?
No, it felt too real to be an illusion.
Those things we saw flickering in and out, that's exactly what I saw earlier this morning. Does this mean the Imanakraish is real?
So you were just bullshitting us the whole time.
Wait, what?
Behold! The Imanakraish has come, just as your princessin had prophesied. Come, my people, a new chapter awaits us.
Indeed, Main Fräulein. We all have witnessed this miracle with our own eyes, and now is the time to celebrate the creation of a new world. Rejoice.
Welcome to the Imanakraish.
He looks so happy. Paimon doesn't have the heart to interrupt her right now.
I do.
Oh, she doesn't seem surprised in the slightest.
She did.
Does that just come with being an experienced adventurer, or...?
If this isn't an illusion, we ought to go and investigate.
Even if it was, shouldn't we investigate?
I got an idea. If you hurt yourself in a dream, you wake up right away, don't you?
Okay, you go first.
Yes, you have a point.
Right? So come on, Kazaha, hit me.
I'd rather not. How about you hit me instead?
But that'll hurt real bad.
Hey, there'll be no need for any of that. Just leave it to us. Hey, Traveler, can Paimon hit you?
what I was talking about.
I like your senses of humor, me hearties. An illusion. So, talking boats and squirrels are just an illusion to humans, huh?
Now, it's understandable, old chap. Haven't you heard? As humans grow older, they forget many important things and lose many of their abilities.
Aye, so they do. A pity, to be sure. Thinking back, in all those years I spent sailing with the fleet, I would have never imagined that one day I'd be laughing over something like this. Well then, me lads and lasses, don't you want to take a wee gander at all the places you're so curious about?
Of course, but how do we get there?
By boat.
Look, here.
At what?
Blimey, at me, of course. Oh, that's right. I forgot to introduce myself. I'm the smartest ship you'll find in all of these parts. The names... just call me whatever takes your fancy.
Don't you have a name?
That I do. I just can't remember it. All I know is that I came here from Inazuma.
In that case, Paimon shall name you... Mitaboru! How's that? All the other ships in Inazuma seem to have names ending in Ru, too.
And does she know what that word means? Even not being from Inazuma.
Mitaboru! Ha! That'll do nicely.
We could have a different boat.
You're lucky to have met me. I can sail through the choppiest seas with ease. There isn't a wave out there that can capsize me, so...
And the boat isn't so used, but this would be a nice chance to introduce a new boat design for us to change, like the wing glider.
Come aboard, and I'll take you wherever you'd like to go.
Ah, how very kind of you, old chap. Unlike that animal archon who abandoned us here.
Animal archon?
You know, the animal archon of Mondstadt. Don't you know, some of these islands used to be Mondstadt's mountaintops. Once upon a time, the animal archon sliced them off to neaten the place up and chucked them into the ocean. My great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather was on one of the mountaintops and got sent flying here along with it. Wretched animal archon.
How could that happen?
And we've been living here for generations since then. Fortunately, there were a few other squirrel families that got stranded on these islands as well, so we built ourselves a kingdom here. The good thing is that there are no predators or competitors around. All the pine cones on this island are ours for the taking. The bad thing is, we're stuck here.
Well, what would they do if they weren't stuck here? For a squirrel, this seems to be a perfect life.
Didn't see that coming. Sounds like the Imranachtreich is a kingdom of squirrels.
Hold thy tongue!
Paimon, please do not make such slanderous statements. The Imranachtreich is, of course, a kingdom of night ravens.
Hey, lad. Yes, you. You're from Inazuma, aye? That makes us brothers, ha! Every young lad of Inazuma has to pluck up the courage to set sail on an adventure one day. So, are you coming?
To set sail is to leave one's homeland and travel far away.
Aye. You need lots of courage and just a dash of heartlessness. Because once you leave, you may never return. But if you stay, you're forever a prisoner in your own heart.
Inspiring words, Mitaboru. And you're right. The Wanderer's spirit runs in my blood. I'll go with you.
You should have been the one to name the boat.
My friends, are you coming too? I want to take a look at the strange phenomena on that island. Also, I smell ancient timber and waterproof varnish on this boat. The scent is indeed from Inazuma, so I believe he speaks the truth.
Huh. Well, what does everyone think?
Oz, lay down the gangplank. Thy princessin shall take to the seas.
Can we all fit inside?
Let's all go. It'll definitely be an experience.
Ha! Great. And we're off.
Safe travels.
Just a second. So Meatoboro, maybe meatball. Just well. Okay.
Good going, lads and lassies. Meatoboro admires your bravery. How long have you been here?
No, oh, I cannot.
It's not your first time. Ha! Well, I never.
The island where a strange phenomena happened didn't happen to all islands. To me, it seemed like there was a tower. I didn't pay attention. But that or that was the castle, and there was the awesome trees. That will be the least important one to check at the moment. There's a peculiar tree over there.
Take all your personal belongings with you, and mind your step as you disembark.
Look! There's something over there!
Wow. It's... Let's take a closer look.
Couldn't we just, like, whistle to him or something now instead of having to go to one of those parts? What's the name? Waypoint.
Well, I certainly didn't expect to see you here.
This is a bonsai pot, right? It's nice, but it looks like it's been a little neglected.
If it was dead, I'd say that. It looks like there isn't anything planted in it.
This bonsai was in my family for many generations. I saw it once in a Tenryo Commission warehouse. But it looked quite different from how it does now.
Sure, he got it back. And that's something he could take along with him.
At that time, there was a withered tree inside.
He can leave at the...
Why would someone crooks? Keep the plant in there if it's dead?
It's a way of sending a secret message. It indicated that there was something hidden inside the flower pot. There was a letter buried down at the bottom, which told of an ancient secret in my clan. I did not take the bonsai with me after reading the letter, which means it should still be in the warehouse now. I wonder who removed the plant and placed the pot here.
So the bonsai pot belonged to your ancestors? Seems a shame to leave it empty like this. Kaza, what do you think about maybe putting a little something inside it?
All right. Though I still don't understand why it has appeared here, I can give that a try.
Oh. Ah, that's a loading screen. That's quite different from all the others I've had so far.
Paimon knew it wasn't gonna be that simple!
Oh. Where's Kazuha? Huh? Where are we?
Yeah! Everyone's here! Except for Kazuha!
Kazuha! Where are you? Are you okay?
Is each island gonna be about the story of history of each character?
No response. Well, let's keep an eye out for him.
Look at the decor here. It's like the inside of a grand mansion. I don't think this is a perilous maze. It's somebody's home.
Most curious. What secrets lie within this place, I shall surely uncover.
Oh. Prismatic ramparts can be used to fire arrows of different coloration. You can just bring my ramparts angle or elevation, depression, and rotation and allow it to hit targets in different positions. Prismatic seals of certain colors can be dispelled by arrows of the same color fired by prismatic ramparts. There are three different colors for seals and arrows. After you pick up a prismatic gem, you can unlock a new arrow color at the prismatic rampart. Hang on, let's check this here. A elegantly written note. When I was flipping through some old books today, I found my father's old notes. I read them, of course, he wouldn't mind. As I expected, most of the content concerned forging techniques as well as tricks on how to handle certain ores. The tail end featured a number of hand-drawn crafts, mostly bonsai designs. Well, I suppose this love for them does count as a clan tradition. My son turned 6 this year. His name is Kazuha. He, just as my wife wished, he's coming, and her going were not far apart. To think that it has been 6 years since then, and if she were still here, she would surely be helping my father in the yard. My father lived well in his younger years, and that lifestyle has greatly deteriorated in his later ones. It fills me with shame to admit that I am unable to improve these circumstances. He says that it is not important, however, and that it is instead we who are young who are the key.
It looks like this letter was written by Kazuha's father. So keeping bonsai plants really does run in the family. But the fact that we're even here and could see his father's notes, it just seems so unbelievable.
Same thing. So, unknown chamber. Oh, this is sideways. Two more. And those. A letter. To my dear father Kagehara Kageharu. Ever since the official dissolution of our house, I have packed my bags and left our ancestral home, wandering the world, and I have learned much on this journey. Today, I was reminded of many scenic artworks you drew in your notes as I passed some seaside cliffs by. The sight gave me much to think about. A wondrous leisure is not the tradition of our clan, but the appreciation of scenery surely counts. I believe it was great-grandfather who started that particular practice. I mentioned that he enjoyed planting small trees, loving their supple branches, while grandfather was of a different temperament, enjoyed fiddling with stones more. When I was young, our backyard was full of the many curious stones that grandfather collected. Back then, I thought the ground was littered with treasure, but now that I know much more of the world, I can be quite certain that at least some of them were sword testing stones that grandfather brought back from the forging station. I knew precious little about stones then, believing them all to be of great value. But can there really be so much treasure in life? I am writing this letter as a rest in a shady spot on a hilltop. I intend to burn this letter shortly before using the water on the mountain stream to quench the remnant embers. This way, I believe that this message will reach you, so you can no longer receive letters. I dismiss the servants after your passing and sell our various assets. It isn't worth much, but it's enough to live on. I fear that our bonsais may not have fared as well as I hoped. I saw what I could get my hands on to pay our debts, but save for our great-grandfather's old relic, it was confiscated by the Imperial Commission. That said, I suspect that staying in their storehouse may have been a better fate for it than remaining in my hands. I have not been here in a long while. The wind whistling through the mountains is just as lovely as it was when you first brought me here many years ago. As setting off again. Farewell, Kadeha Kazuha. Ah, so this is when he returned to Yozumu.
Looks like a letter Kazuha wrote while he was traveling.
Oh, what a sad letter. Lord Kazuha.
No, didn't change. Oh, I had to grab another one. I thought I had the power to change to yellow now.
It's been a lucky day.
Stand with me. Speed of light.
Get moving.
Hey.
Lightning.
Say no more.
Go as planned. Incoming! Yeah. With sword comes shadow!
For me!
Hey! Our bond is strong!
This isn't over!
I swear by my sword!
Segwa!
I'm ready!
Get to the chase!
Cut down battle!
Let's get down to business!
Don't blink!
Huh? Perfect distance!
Dissipate! Go as one! Incoming! Out of my way!
Confess!
Nowhere to hide!
My flame! Hide!
No.
no switchable colors. I just grabbed it. Didn't I just? Didn't I click? Does it there to see what the best for all of them instead of skipping one? When you find a melodic omamori, you can pick them up and carry them with you. Okay. Place me melodic omamori in a special shrine to cause certain changes in the surrounding area. Okay, we have to place two. Be a chest or
The flesh resides in society, while the heart yearns for the natural world. Such has been the way of the Kaidaharas for many generations. Kazuha, the future of this clan will one day be in your hands. When that time comes, remember to always stay true to yourself.
I heard an old man say something about the Kaedeharas.
Sounds like it might be Kazuha's grandfather.
Listen carefully, Kazuha. A Kaidahara blade is not forged for the purpose of harming people.
Father, what are you carving?
It's a rock garden. I'm modeling it after the scenery I saw on my travels abroad. It'll go in my bonsai later. Work has been so busy these years, I've barely had a moment to spend with my grandson. I hope he doesn't take after me. When he's older, he should get out there and see more of the world.
I believe the other voice belongs to Lord Kazuha's father.
Oh, I see. We have ventured into Lord Kazuha's memory.
But I think I need to... No, hang on, Kazuha is here. There was more stuff down here, wasn't it? Kazuha's right there.
Barbados, guide us. Stand with me. With sword comes shadow.
Don't go back. Rest.
I dare you.
I think I lost it again by doing that. Come on. So I think I grabbed it before. Where it helps. I think they are all pointing right now. Yellow notes. Something quite amusing happened today that I just have to preserve in my diary. The young master got a little tipsy. Well, a lot tipsy. It must be said that the young master is way underage to drink at all. Not knowing any better, he must have confused his father's dream with his own, mistaking that glass of wine for grape juice. From a distance, I noticed someone practicing martial arts in the courtyard. I expected it to be our young master, which I wasn't wrong in assuming, but I never expected to see him in such a state. That is to say, utterly sloshed. He greeted me in high spirits, and if it wasn't for his lobster red face, I wouldn't have suspected anything. Overdrinking on a summer night is hardly a crime, but considering his age, I simply felt that I had to keep an eye on him. At first, I wanted to pretend I didn't see it. I even made a detour to take things out to the backyards so as to spare him the embarrassment. By the time I finished my work, the young master was already lying on the steps, asleep. What a rare sight it is to see this precocious young man revealing the side of him. A right sight indeed. Another servant and I quietly carried the young master back inside and prepared some tea and snacks to help him sober up and ease the discomfort later. He might have called his parents' names while sleeping. His eyes closed, he looked so contented. Perhaps he had dreamed of some happy moments in his past. Dear young master, you still have a long life ahead of you. There shall be plenty of opportunities to drink in the future. That is. There is a chest there. No.
There you are!
Huh? Where did you all go?
This place is a maze! We all got trapped inside except for you!
I've been stuck in this room the whole time and can't seem to find a way out. I have to say, this place looks a lot like my childhood bedroom.
Wouldn't it be more important for him to learn about the things we learned?
If this is your home, why would you be trapped here? Is the maze trying to keep you out?
You tell Kasu about everything that just happened.
It appears that this whole maze is modeled after my family home. And all the conversations you heard in there are in fact words once spoken by my father and grandfather. You said that the maze is trying to keep me out. Indeed, I'm the only one unable to explore this place.
Can we just open the door?
I think these unusual structures are some kind of mirage. According to what Kazuha said, all this seems to be constructed based on Kazuha's memory.
But why should Lord Kazuha be the only one excluded?
Maybe that comes from me too. To me, what is past is gone. Everything in the world is guided by its own rules, and as for people, we can never relive the past. I think that this belief is the reason why the mirage was keeping me out.
Oh, I can get behind that. It's a very sensible way of looking at things.
All our thoughts have consequences. I don't consider it strange, and I don't think it's anything you should be worried about. We got in here by touching the bonsai, didn't we? So perhaps, if we touch it again...
So he was trapped here and he didn't even try it. Yeah, so the next ones I gotta be careful because I almost started this cutscene without exploring everything.
We're back!
Hey, look! That whole mountain's changed completely!
Wait. Everyone, I might have an explanation. The changes in the mirage could be related to the bonsai. My father once mentioned that this pot was originally part of a collection belonging to my great-grandfather. He adored his bonsai and always took great care of them. When our family fell upon hard times, my grandfather traveled far and wide looking for a way to save the clan. However, during that time, my great-grandfather became gravely ill. He knew my grandfather had no interest in bonsai, so before his death, he gave most of his carefully crafted bonsai away. This is the only one he retained.
Dyed letter with that secret in it, right?
Yes, and to give his son something to remember him by. My grandfather returned quickly as he could. But my great-grandfather had already passed away. They never got the chance to say goodbye to each other before the end. After that, my grandfather would spend long periods of time standing in front of this bonsai, lost in thought. Eventually, he started to make his own bonsai. Unlike his father, he preferred arranging rock gardens instead of plants. Perhaps influenced by my father also took a liking to crafting bonsai. Back then, our courtyard was filled with all kinds of them. And this flower pot was passed down to me as a family treasure. It's certainly no coincidence that it appeared here and became the entrance to the mirage. It's almost as if... it's giving me a chance to make up for past regrets.
Regrets about what?
There was once a time when the Kaidaharas were an illustrious clan in Inazuma. After the Raiden Gokaden incident, our clan's fortunes took a turn for the worse. By the time of my generation, our downfall was complete. Later, I fled Inazuma as I didn't want to be arrested. With no one left in the Kaidahara clan, the authorities confiscated everything in our home, including this bonsai. like my ancestors before me, I think I'd like to try it out for myself. Recreate a favorite scene from my travels and place it into this pot.
Oh.
Since the contents of this bonsai affect the mirage, I'd at least like to try my hand at making something. But what style? Should I use plants for the bonsai, like my great-grandfather? Or rocks, like my father and grandfather? Perhaps a rock garden would suit me better.
So do you need any supplies to make this bonsai?
Rocks.
I think I'll need a set of tools and some rocks that can be carved and made into decorations.
Got it. We'll help you look.
We might just get lucky. If the pot's here, then surely other stuff related to crafting bonsai can't be far away.
I concur. Lord Kazuha, take heart in your search, for my retinue and I shall help you retrieve your missing treasures.
Thank you, everyone.
I guess some rocks are. There. There seems to be a path all the way here. And now I should climb like that.
Speed of light.
This is an enemy. Maybe it's part of collectibles in this island. Ah, those are from all stats. Probably have food for stamina. I never use them here. Stamina is... decrease stamina consumption. Now I need to recover, start stamina. And then yeah, how much? Just that? And I have to wait. Oh. This doesn't really help. Maybe I should use one that decreases consumption.
Mm-hmm.
No, no, no. Damn. She was standing there. Why does it take so long to refill? Oh no, why did I jump? Why did I jump? Can I get another one? That was quite close. Death before anything. What if somebody hits me and I fall down?
With sword from shadow.
Keep moving.
I'll settle this.
Like that.
Going a little too smoothly today.
As well.
Wow, it's a new place!
Okay. Where's Kazuha?
As was the case last time, only Lord Kazuha is missing.
Don't worry, leave it to us.
That's nice. Looks cool.
Thank you.
Come on, go forward. Okay, no. Oh. This was already there. Hang on, I explore the area, look for the exit. I'm afraid I may leave something behind. Like that, I didn't activate that yet. Things are, I'm not 100% sure that door here at the beginning is where I'll have to come back to.
This will do. Ah, Kazuha. You've come just at the right moment. What do you think of this rock carving?
It's very intricate.
I based it on a mountain scene I saw in a book. You know, there are nations in this world where the mountains reach all the way up into the clouds. If only I had the chance to see them with my own eyes.
Father, you can go anywhere whenever you want.
That's not true. Though the Kaedehara clan is far from what it used to be, I still bear all the same responsibilities as the clan heads before me. But then again, continuing in the way of our forefathers, sacrificing everything for our declining clan, is it really worth it?
But I don't understand.
Kazuha, there's one thing I want you to always remember. Family ties are important, but you ought to not let them hold you back. Family only exists because of the people in it. If we are unhappy, how can we hope to build a joyful one? The events of the past have had a profound impact on our family, but they are not your burden to carry. If you ever grow tired of this tedious life, just drop everything and go off on a journey. See the world. Remember, Kazuha, don't let yourself get tied down in life.
Yes, Father.
Oh. Okay, glitch through the... Yeah, I don't know if you're there anyway, but... There are two paths. Okay, this is where I came from. Here.
I've heard a lot about you, Mr. Kaedehara. It's my honor to meet you today.
It is Kazuha's honor to duel with a military man like yourself. Kazuha, get ready.
Oh. Incoming!
Huh? Show me
with
what you've got!
Shadow.
Peace. I connected here. Oh, we can usually just drop one block. Okay. In this one I don't have. But couldn't dispatch the either way. Hang on. Not very close. Okay, let's go back there. I don't think I'll be able to activate that. Where is it? Oh, here. I'll definitely have to change again, but what happens if I flip it while it's going, that continues. Okay, now where did I have to place them?
I'm sorry, but I just don't understand.
Kazuha, have you forgotten our promise?
You really want to give it all up? But even if we're having a rough time, you still have me by your side. Can't I be of any help? When you were my age, you were already helping Grandfather out. Am I so incompetent that I'm a disappointment to you? Or...
Kazuha! Now you're blaming yourself for all of this? That's why I failed you as a father. The Kaidehara clan has been paying the price for our past mistakes ever since your great-grandfather's generation. To this day, we have never fully recovered from it. Though we are a family of bladesmiths, you don't have to devote your life to the family craft. If a wounded animal wants to escape from a trap, it has to sacrifice the hind leg that was caught. You might think of this as a loss, but staying in the trap has far more deadly consequences. Enough now, Kazuha. As the head of the family, I failed to revitalize our clan. You never blamed me for not giving you the life promised to you by our heritage, and I'm grateful enough for that. All these generations of suffering, let's end them today. From now on, live your life with no burdens. Don't worry. I'll carry the blame for abandoning our family business.
Father, please don't. You should not be to blame for not upholding our family name. Even if that day comes, let me share the burden with you. Let's just wait and see. Sooner or later, I will have to lead the Kaidehara clan. When the time comes, I'll deal with all our problems.
It should be over there. But what about up here? Oh, it's closed.
Hey, think you're tough enough to go against me? Yeah, no response! What's wrong? Scared?
Did you really think it would be wise to pick a fight with the Kaidehara clan?
To the fairy!
Stand no with me!
Clan is no longer what it used to be.
That's Kazuha's voice!
We've been hearing his voice for a while now.
But why can't he hear us? Looks like it's just an illusion. This isn't the Kazuha who came here with us.
Well, I can't move the camera.
Maybe if I were more adept in the sword arts, I'd be able to share my father's burdens.
Is that what Fontaine movies look like?
This won't do. I'm getting distracted by family matters and making too many mistakes.
I can't jump. I'm not with my characters.
I yearn to hear the song of Nightingale.
Oh.
My patient ears ready to attend.
That's nice.
A veil of mist obscures the western skies. Into its midst, a silver moon descends. No one is fighting a losing battle, and yet never once falter. This shall be my father's legacy.
Thought we might find you trapped here again.
Yeah, it seems those are the rules.
We entered that maze in the Mirage again. But the scene was different this time.
The mood was more deflated, and the place more humbly furnished. Yes, that makes sense. What you saw was the Kaidahara clan in decline.
We saw you in the Mirage too, but you looked a little different than now.
Indeed, I most certainly agree.
Compared to the Lord Kazuha before us now, the Mirage we saw appeared lost, with the burden of fate weighing heavily upon him.
I can confirm that. His fate was a heavy burden indeed.
That means I am older and wiser now. I'm sorry you had to see my less mature former self. For a long time after leaving Inazuma, I've lived the life of a drifter. But this is no bad thing, because I learned much from the experience. I wish that I could have met my past self, too. If he saw me, I know that he would understand. Life is a long journey. And that's why I must travel far and wide. Just as I thought, the bonsai is the key to entering the Mirage.
Come on, let's continue looking for the rock garden.
Damn, this event is gonna be long, isn't it? I have more things to do for Kazuha. Yeah, I'm not gonna continue today. I'll try not to take so long to play. To continue this story here, but there are some bridges now. I mean, I saw there was a broken one here, but maybe it's completely different. I think I have to keep changing, so I have. So there will probably be different puzzles. I don't know. I'll try to continue soon with Genshin. Let's stop right here.